opportunity for the team that tries to get on the bubble. How do you think the team has kind of handled mentally this last 10-game stretch or so, where the calculus and the trajectory of the season has kind of changed as it's kept winning and winning?
We've done a great job. I think they've done a great job, not just the last 10 days, but you know, for quite a while now.
Do you think if you guys win tomorrow's game, you deserve to be in?
Yeah, I'm not going to go there. It's just one game at a time, and you know, we're focused on is obviously Tennessee and trying to, you know, play really well against a really good team that's obviously highly ranked and deservedly so, with a very high RPI.
And Lamar getting SEC Player of the Week and things. Can you just talk about his journey this season? I know early in the year, kind of inconsistent, had the stretch where he was suspended for a few games and things, and now, you know, arguably is the catalyst a little bit to some of what you guys have done. Just his journey and how you've seen him progress through
the year. Yeah, really excited for him. He's played great, and it was very well deserved, being named SEC Player of the Week. You know, he's playing like a, you know, a really good floor game and point guard. Look at his assist totals here the last over the 6-7 game span. You know, he's, if you just took those last 6-7 games, I think he'd probably lead the league or be close to it. But he's playing great defense too. I mean, like, he's forced 8 turnovers in the last game out of that opposite point guard position. Who, you know, Gravitt's really playing well for him. He's a difference maker in how South Carolina's been playing. And, you know, played well against us, but, you know, at the end of the day, there were a couple threes that he wasn't on them. You know, he did some things where, you know, it wasn't Lamar's fault, and yet he still ended up forcing 8 turnovers. And he's done that in a number of games. And you're going back to think about Georgia, you know, he got a very big steal in our previous home game. You know, early on against Ole Miss. I mean, he's just playing a good all-around game. And that's what's most exciting. Like, he's being dominant at both ends of the floor, with and without the ball. And playing better defense, you know, really excited about his defense. You know, like, he's learning to be really a dominant player when he doesn't have the ball. And he's always just been a guy that only, you know, when he had the ball, he was doing things, whether he was guarding it or with the ball, but now he's doing things off the ball defensively. I mean, he's really playing well.
Saw Tennessee twice last year. How similar is this year's team?
Yeah, they're a lot better than they were a year ago, you know, as we are. Both teams have improved vastly from where we were a year ago. And, you know, I mean, you look at Grant Williams and Schofield, those guys are just absolute studs and really good players. You know, one's a sophomore, one's a junior. They run a lot of stuff through them. They take the most shots. They're the 1-2 in terms of scoring. They're out there, but their guard play, Bone, assist to turnover is incredible. I mean, he's a really good point guard. You look at Bowden, how he's shooting the ball on the year. You really have to pay attention to him. You know, I think Alexander's a guy that's underappreciated for all the things he does, all the dirty work. Rebounding, defending, blocking shots, protecting the rim. You know, Turner gives him great minutes coming in, instant offense, really shoots the ball well, probably the best shooter on their team. They have a lot of depth. You know, Walker's a very good big, he comes off the bench, Fulkerson. They can play big, they can play small. They'll play Schofield starting the games at the 3 and then move them to the 4. They're very aggressive defensively, a really good defensive team. They play primarily man-to-man and gets out of pressures. They're very good in executing their offense and run a lot of motion, a lot of different looks, little flex sets. And, you know, he's one of the best coaches in the game, not just in our league. And when you win 700-and-something games and been in the tournament 22 times and, you know, been to Final Fours, things that Coach Barnes has done, and it's pretty incredible. He's won everywhere he's been.
You talked in the preseason how this was a tight-knit team. They had a good bond about them in the preseason. How has that manifested itself over the last 10 games or so? How has that?
I think that's just become closer and closer as our season's progressed. And, you know, it definitely helps you. You know, it definitely helps you when you have guys that are playing for each other and are really, there's good team leadership. That makes a huge difference.
several of your coaching stops. The year three has been a special year at those places and things. Has that just kind of been coincidental, or is that just kind of how long it takes to get your system in, I guess?
I mean, typically when you take over a program, in most cases, I mean, Coach Barnes, for example, this is his third year. And, you know, you typically when you take over, you know, you're making a change because things aren't going great to begin with. So you're not inheriting, you know, and it happens once in a while, and you'll come in and you'll inherit five pros, and it's easy. But usually that's not the case. Usually, you know, you're starting over. And so typically in the third year, you've either got to be making some progress or they're going to get tired of you.
But you talked about the competitiveness of the league all year, but when you have nine teams within two games of each other right in the middle of the pack all bunched up, it really shows out.
Yeah, and our league is so good. I mean, you just continue to see it night in and night out how tough it is. You know, we talked about it from the beginning, and you hear every coach talk about it. You hear everyone talk about it. And I think it's really, indicative of the fact that it's the truth. I mean, anybody can beat anybody. There are no easy games, and every game you've got to show up and play your best to have a chance to win. You know, look at South Carolina. I mean, they had, we were very fortunate to come out of there with a win the other day. And they're tough. They're hard-nosed. They just crushed at Auburn, you know, a week earlier at home, who's, their most likely conference champion. So it's just really tough.
What's your opinion on the NCAA using the quadrant system for the tournament?
Yeah, I mean, they are always trying to update their analytics and how they do things. And, I hope that one of the factors that they used to always talk about is how you're playing lately. You look at your last third and the eye test, actually watching games. You know, people on the committee are watching games every night, and that's their job. It's not just the numbers. It's also actually looking and watching and seeing how teams are playing. I've had a lot of people I've known over the years who've been on the committee, and there's a lot that goes into, what they do in terms of them studying each conference and each team, and really looking at it closely. So there's a lot. And they've allowed some of the media, in the past to come in there and see how they do things. So it's very interesting.
Any more questions?
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.